Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome back to my kitchen. Today we are going to be talking about some more flower seeds, most notably the flower seeds that we are going to be growing for our hardy annual flowers. That means we are going to plant these seeds in the fall. They are going to overwinter for us in the garden, either without protection or in an unheated low tunnel or unheated hoop house. They are going to bloom the following spring, and that will be the backbone of our spring garden. Now for frame of reference, I'm in Kentucky, that's zone 6B7. I do get cold weather. It's not as cold as some places, but it's definitely not as warm as other places. You know, I get plenty of frost and hard freeze and snow. While I can't guarantee that these things will overwinter for you, it is something to consider because they do have varying degrees of cold tolerance. So the first thing I am going to be growing this year, or attempting to grow, are California poppies. California poppies, this is a first for me. I've never grown California poppies before. This is the Mission Bells variety. I've grown plenty of poppies in the past, so hopefully we'll have some luck with these. I'm also attempting to grow for the, I think, second time, is Robinson's Blend Painted Daisies. Now, technically these are a perennial, but I'm attempting to start them in the fall, start the seed in the fall, so that they can grow and maybe bloom next year, or we'll just see what happens with those. That's just one that I have extra. So not a hardy annual, but I figured I'd put it in this seed haul anyway. I also have some Green Mist Ami, or however you say it. It's the Ami Visnaga. I don't know how to say these things. I've only read about them. Either way, these grow extremely easy as a hardy annual here in my garden. These do not need any kind of protection from the frost or the snow. They're plenty hardy. I usually have 100% success rate with those. I should also mention before we get going with these, I usually direct sow and transplant or start these seeds at the end of September here where I live. That's about 5-ish weeks before my first frost date. Ideally, we want these seeds to germinate and kind of establish themselves a little bit, and then the first frost comes. So that date will kind of vary depending upon where you live as well. Next up, we have some sweet peas. This is just the Elegance Blend. I have a very limited space in my backyard, so I tend to buy multiple packets of different types of seeds. We also have some classic romantic bachelor's buttons. This is one of my favorite bachelor's button varieties. I'm not quite sure why it's in this big old pamphlet. I mean, it's bachelor's buttons. It's not rocket science. That's the great thing about bachelor's buttons, is they're so easy. Again, this is another flower that needs no protection from me in my yard. I can direct sow these in the fall. They will overwinter and they will bloom the next season. I really love bachelor's buttons for that reason, actually. My packets are sliding everywhere. Also in this haul, we have some Marble Arch Butterfly Salvia. I don't know the actual technical name of this one. This is, let me see, Salvia Hermanum. I don't know how to say it. But these do need a unheated low tunnel or some frost blanket to overwinter here. But usually if I use a frost blanket, I have pretty good results with these. Also, we have some Scabiosa or pincushion flowers. This is just the Renee's Garden Grandmother's Pincushion Mix. I haven't grown this mix specifically before, but I'm hoping it's going to be a really nice kind of blend of those blues, pinks, dark burgundies, and kind of maroon colors that are really beautiful. This is another one that I've had marginal success overwintering these without protection. It just depends on the year. Sometimes they'll all overwinter. Sometimes none of them will make it. So it really just depends on the year and what the weather's like that year. But I do grow these in the unheated low tunnel just to be sure and to make sure they make it. Other sweet peas we have Chiffon Elegance, and we have Perfume Delight, and we have Bouquet Blend. Can you tell that these were on sale? There was a massive sweet pea sale when I bought these from both places that I bought these from, and I couldn't resist. Also got watermelon, and I'm trying to look through my pile here to see if I have any more. Admittedly, I'm like obsessed with sweet peas. Oh yeah, and I have Elegance Pink Diana. Going for a lot of pink shades this year, pink and pastel. I should mention that these absolutely need a low tunnel where I live to overwinter successfully. I have tried it without any kind of protection before, and I had like a 25% survival rate. It wasn't very good, definitely not worth it. So these will go into the unheated hoop house over winter. But once they're in that hoop house and I'm taking care of them, making sure the temperature isn't getting too cold, these will flourish. They'll do great. Also, while I'm looking at Johnny's seed packets, we have some Chantilly mix snapdragons. And in addition to those snapdragons, I have just a generic kind of tall maximum blend. And I think I also ordered Madame Butterfly from somewhere. It hasn't come yet. I love snapdragons. Now that I've finally had a year of success with snapdragons, I am so eager to grow as many snapdragons as possible. You guys, I'm obsessed, seriously. For the snapdragons to be successful, I have to transplant them and I have to use a low tunnel and a frost blanket. But as long as we baby them along in the unheated low tunnel, they turn out to be beautiful in the spring. That's the only way that I've found to have success with snapdragons. It just gets so hot here so early in the season. But I'm gonna keep on trying, see if I can make later plantings, kind of experiment with it. Looking at some other odds and ends, I also have dill and some feverfew. I think is technically a perennial, not technically a hardy annual, but I treat it as a hardy annual just because it's so easy to grow. What I do is I sow the seeds in trays and they stay small all winter long, and by, you know, late spring, early summer, they are in full bloom. They're 4 foot tall. They're gorgeous. Super easy to grow. I think you could probably even direct sow feverfew, even though I've never really done that. You could probably do so and have some good success with that as well. Also have some calendula. Calendula is difficult here in my zone. It does have some cold hardiness, but it doesn't like to be wet. My soil is always wet and cold. Not really the best combination. So I do have to protect these. This whole process of growing cut flowers really is trial and error in determining what works best for you in your yard. Next, I have some Cat's Formula scented stock. Again, was kind of the first year that I was marginally successful with scented stock. We're gonna grow those again in the unheated hoop house, but we are gonna protect them more with a heavier row cover. It got down to about -2 Fahrenheit one night here where I live, and my row cover was not heavy enough. Had a lot of frost damage. The plants were, it was bad. So we're gonna try that again with the scented stock and use heavier row covers inside the unheated low tunnel. My last packet from Johnny's, of course, is the Larkspur. Next year, I'm gonna be growing the Fancy Smoky Eyes. I thought this one was really nice. It's kind of a mix between a white and a really soft pale lavender that I think is absolutely gorgeous. This past year, we grew the mix. The mix is fun and everything, but I always like growing just specific colors. I did not protect these at all last year. I had a great success rate with overwintering. They overwintered excellent. I always direct sow these just because they seem to hate transplants. So another easy one if you're trying your first hardy annual cut flower garden, that might be a good candidate. Also got some Agrostemma. This is the Purple Queen and Pink Contessa mix from Renee's garden. I've never grown this mix before. Usually I just grow the Mila's mix or whatever it's called. And again, these need protection here in my yard. It gets just a little bit too cold for these. I have overwintered these without any frost blankets before, and I had about a 50% success rate. So really, I lost 50% of them. 50% of them bloomed. That might be one to consider, especially if you live somewhere maybe a little bit warmer than I do. This year, I'm going to try to overwinter some annual phlox. This is Dutch Tapestry. I'm not sure if this will work. This is definitely going to be protected. I know for a fact that these can handle some light frost, but I'm not sure that they can handle, you know, the heavier frost that I have going on in the yard. We also have Victorian Posy pansies. This is one of my favorite pansies from Renee's garden. They just have really delicate, kind of fluffy little ruffles. Again, I'm not quite sure you would need a hoop house for this, or rather, I'm not quite sure you would need an unheated low tunnel. I have not tried it, but we're gonna try it this year and see what happens. We also have two types of Love in the Mist. We have the Mulberry Rose Nigella, and we have Chocolate and Cream. I've never grown either one of these, but I assume that they are very much like any of the other, you know, types of Love in the Mist. I do put these in an unheated low tunnel. I've tried them without a low tunnel before. Again, 50-50 success rate, depending upon how harsh the winter is. I try to give kind of guidelines of what I do and how I get the hardy annuals to overwinter, and try to give you guys some advice because people always ask, but it really is, it's up to you, it's up to your garden, it's up to the weather. It really is different from one season to the next. Last but not least, we have Angel's Choir Shirley Poppies. This is another one that needs absolutely no help from me to overwinter. I direct sow these in the fall in a well-amended bed. Usually they germinate within a couple weeks and they overwinter phenomenally here in my garden, and they bloom the following spring. They look absolutely great. I feel like that's a lot of seeds. I don't know where I'm gonna put all this stuff, but we're gonna find a spot. That's really about it for this video. As always, I hope it was helpful. If it was, be sure to leave me a comment, ask a question, tell me your own experiences. I always enjoy reading the comments. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I'd absolutely love to have you. We're putting new content out all the time, trying to just have a really, really beautiful cut flower garden. I hope that you guys are having an amazing day, and I will talk to y'all later. Bye, guys.